I wanted to give you a high-level overview of the structure of Mike's code to give you a sense of how to organize your own. And also, I wanted to explain some of the elements we may not have encountered in the console in the examples we've been through. At the very top here, we have a script tag, which actually loads our D3 library. Right below the script tag, we have a style tag, which can be used to add styles to the graphics and elements created through D3. Much of the logic of the visualization comes next, wrapped in a draw function, and just a small point. All of these first three things I've covered are contained within the head tag of our HTML page. As soon as we open our body tag, we put an SVG with class chart to hold the visualization. And finally, the last bit of JavaScript loads our external data file and then calls our draw function. Because JavaScript is asynchronous, the code you see here isn't necessarily executed in the order it is written here. Whenever a browser reads in an HTML file, it reads it from top to bottom and parses each line of either HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or SVG. But even though a JavaScript function may be parsed, doesn't necessarily mean it will be executed. And one last point of frustration, often for newcomers to JavaScript, is the idea of a callback. All a callback is a function that gets executed once another function completes. We will see in just a second how D3 leverages callbacks. The first line of JavaScript that actually gets executed in this HTML is the last line that loads our external data file. Once the data file is loaded, and only then, does the draw callback function get executed. And again, the draw function is what contains most of the logic to build our visualization. And since the draw function and all of the code contained within it need some data to bind to and visualize, and only when the data is fully loaded does it get passed as the argument to the draw function.